Hi everybody, this is JTadventures and this is T doing the review today. Today I'm going to do a review on the kabar short tanto, not the big one, this is the short one, and this is the partially serrated one. I got this a couple weeks ago, and it's been a really good knife. I haven't really been able to use it, but just for like small tasks, it's been really good for that kind of stuff, and I think it online you can find it for around $45 to $50, and then it costs a little bit more for the kydex sheath, but I thought the kydex sheath would be a little bit more versatile and better for outdoor use. You can also get it in the leather sheath, which is also very good, and then you can, if you get the leather sheath, then you can upgrade to this sheath, which is another like $12 if you really want it. First, I'm going to talk about what this knife is used for. It can be, it's mostly used for like a tactical fighting knife. Because of its size, and because of it, here, that's a size comparison. Because of its size, and because of its blade shape, I suppose then it would be a more of a fighting knife, tactical knife kind of thing. More than like a utility or a survival knife, but it can still be used for that. The knife in its sheath is 10.5 inches, and it's K-Bar's kydex sheath, and they made it so they're really lightweight and really durable. That's hard kydex, and then it has a, on the back, I thought was really cool is the drainage hole, and it kind of looks like a frowny face. So that's there's a drainage hole because the steel choice, and I'll get to that later. And then it's flat on the back, and then it has like the knife, like the shape of the knife poking out on the top. And then it has the holes and the slots for webbing and paracord to attach it any different way you want it. And it says right here, it says K-Bar right underneath the button. And this is the older kind where they had the button on the handle and the button across the tang. And I like that. It just makes it a little bit more secure. And I'm not going to be using this as a fighting knife because I don't get into too many knife fights. So it's good to have it secure in there. And then it has a little equipment dangle type of thing. I don't really know what it's for. And then it has the nylon strap belt loop, and it's pretty small compared to my finger. It's a small belt loop. That was my first impression of it. I'm like, whoa, that's really small, but it fits my belt fine. And then it has nylon straps, as I just said. And then it has no quick attach, but that's fine. So that's the sheath. It's very, very nice. And you just take these off, and I'm sure you've seen this before, but I'll just show it because for the reference. It has these little bumps, and you have to push down the sheath, and in the box it comes with instructions. You have to push down the sheath right there and then pull out the knife. So let's get on to the knife. Here's a knife. First we'll talk about the specs and all that good stuff. It has a 5-inch blade, a little over 5-inch blade, for like knife laws and stuff like that. They require under 6 inches, so that's good that they thought about that. And then the handle is 4 inches, but it's really small. Most people's hands like go over the butt cap or the pommel. Mine's right there. It's still pretty small. But that's good because it's nice and fast. It's really fast. I think it weighs like 5.5 ounces. That's a rough estimate. And then this is the tanto. So there's the tanto point. And it's really sharp. One thing I thought about after I bought this is that this is probably the hardest knife to sharpen because it has the serrations, the flat, and then the tanto point. So that's probably really hard. I haven't had to sharpen it yet, but it's really hard. It probably will be really hard to sharpen. It's 9.5 inches overall, so that's a good for like a good medium size. And it has the cretonne handle. The cretonne handle is a little textured. You can't see it, but it's a little textured, and it fits your hand really good. It's very ergonomic. And then it has like little cut-ins for a little bit more traction, so that's good. See how it just forms to your hand, it goes out and then in. And it has a hollow grind and a 20 degree angle with a epoxy powder coated blade, which is a really, really good coating. It's one of my favorites. And then a little over an inch of serrations. And on most kabar knives, this is 1095, which is my favorite steel. You have to have it, keep it lubricated, as you probably heard before. But it's really a tough steel, and it holds an edge really long. So I haven't had to sharpen this yet. And then there's the K-Bar's round serrations. Right there. And then it is full tang, as you can see there. And so that's good to know that it's full tang, so it won't break on you like those stupid hollow handled ones with all the crappy survival crap equipment in it. The survival equipment is good to have, but the knife just won't hold up. And then it has K-Bar Aline New York right there, or it says Aline NY, and then it has USA, and this is made in the USA, for if you wanted to know that. And if you're thinking about buying this knife and you're wondering if it's like too small or stuff like that, if you're buying a knife to use it in the like the outdoors, I wouldn't probably go with a tanto. I'd probably just go with like a Bowie knife or some sort of knife. I wouldn't go with a tanto, but I got this just for like everyday uses. It's not an EDC, but I guess it could be. You just have to check your laws and restrictions for wherever you live. And so, if you're looking for an outdoors knife, that's K-Bar, I'd go with the Heavy Bowie or the USMC, something like that. So that's all the specs on it so far, I guess. Well, it's really, really thick. It's thicker than the USMC, if you wanted to know. And yeah, so if you're looking for a good, just everyday like usage, like if you're looking for a fighting knife, anything like that, then this is your knife right here. There's also a larger tanto, which you can get if you're into that kind of stuff, but I just went with this because it's nice and compact and light, nice and lightweight. So that's my review on the K-Bar short tanto. Remember to subscribe because we got a lot more coming. See ya.